The Alfa 164 occupies a unique spot in the Milanese marque's history. While it's the last ever model Alfa Romeo developed as an independent company, it is also the first designed on a platform shared with Fiat. It can also be considered the first, and so far the last, large Alfa Romeo saloon to achieve relative market success, selling just under 270,000 units over 10 years. However, that was a long time ago, and now even the newest 164s are old enough to enjoy classic car status, with prices for the very best survivors gently rising. Here are 5 things you probably didn't know about the Alfa 164. Italy once imposed hefty tax penalties on engines over 2 liters of displacement, which created a healthy market for turbocharged 2 liters cars. Between 1988 and 1991, the Alfa 164 Turbo was equipped with almost the same turbo inline-four used in the Lancia Thema. Part of the quoted horsepower advantage the Alfa 164 had over the Lancia Thema was due to the deletion of the engine's 2 counter-rotating balancing shafts. Apparently, someone decided that Alfa Romeo customers could live with a little less refinement. When it launched in 1987, the 164's fresh, strikingly modern appearance was a world away from the boxy Alfas of yore. But making Pininfarina's swoopy profile possible required some clever engineering on Alfa Romeo's part. The Type 4 platform shared with Fiat and Saab dictated a McPherson strut-type front suspension design, but on the Alfa, the McPherson strut isn't aligned with the wheel's center, thus lowering its top mounts by around 3 cm, allowing a lower bonnet line than its platform sisters. Although the Alfa 164 was only ever sold as a four-door saloon, it doesn't mean alternatives weren't considered. Pininfarina actually made full-scale models of an elegant two-door coupé, a rather lovely station wagon, and even a much less successful convertible. However, such ideas were quashed once Fiat took over Alfa Romeo in late 1986. 2 Alfa 164s were transformed into high-speed fire trucks for use on the company's proving ground, the Balocco test track. One of those cars, no less than a 3-liter V6 Q4, has thankfully been preserved in excellent condition and currently resides in the Alfa Romeo Museum's reserve collection. The Alfa 164 had to be rebadged 168 on some oriental markets because of the number 4's negative connotation in the local culture. So the 4 was replaced with the 8, which is instead considered auspicious. Also very auspicious is subscribing to Roadster Life and clicking on the bell icon to be notified each time a new video goes online. See you next week!